Let us summarize the step one of general procedure. So here we are having three joints, joint N, joint N plus 1, joint N plus 2. There is a link N and link N plus 1 between the two joints. So I am writing the point as, let's assign the joint as joint N, joint N plus 1, joint N plus 2. Similarly, let's assign the links as link N between joint N and joint N plus 1, and link N plus 1, which is between joint N plus 1 and N plus 2. We have to assign a local frame for each joint. We will assign only the X and Z, because Y can be found as a cross multiplication of Z and X. We know that cross multiplication means what? If you cross multiply two vectors, the product will always be in the direction which is perpendicular to both these vectors. So that's why if we are having two vectors, and if you want to find a vector which is perpendicular to both these vectors, we always use the cross product. So we know that X and Z has to be always 90 degree to each other, and Y has to be 90 degree to X and Z. In that case, we will use the cross multiplication ZX, Z cross X, to find out Y. That is what we are telling here. So we will never draw Y as such. We will never draw Y. We will only be drawing X and Z axis for each local frame, and we will not be interested in the Y axis. Okay, now what is the procedure for assigning? So let us look that. The procedure for assigning is that all the joints are represented either by Z axis. So how to draw the Z axis? Now I already told that there can be two kinds of joint. One is a revolute joint, another is a prismatic joint. For revolute joint, we will take the axis of rotation as the Z axis. And for that, we have to use the right hand rule, because the right hand rule only will give the correct direction of Z. And then if we have a prismatic joint, then the Z axis we will choose as the direction in which the linear motion is there for the prismatic joint. So the direction in which the prismatic joint is creating movement, that direction we will assign as the Z axis. Then the axis number of Z, that is very important. The axis number of Z of the joint N should be 1 less than N. That is, it should be named as N minus 1. So joint N will become joint N will become Zn minus 1, joint N plus 1 will have a Z axis Zn, and joint N plus 2 will have a Z axis of Zn plus 1. Now these Z axis are skew lines. Skew lines means they are in different planes and they are at some angle to each other. Now skew lines may either intersect or they may not at all intersect. Anyway, what is to be noted here is that there will be a common normal that connects between two consecutive Z axes. There will always be a common normal. Okay, that common normal is the shortest distance between the two Z axes and is perpendicular to both the Z axes. So if you look at the diagram here, I have drawn that shortest normal as AN here. And AN is between Zn minus 1 and Zn. And this AN is in such a way that it is perpendicular to Zn minus 1, as well as it is perpendicular to Zn. That is called as a common normal, because it is the AN is normal to both Zn as well as Zn minus 1. Okay, so in the procedure, the two steps are over. What is the third step? The third step is talking about this AN, and from that AN how we will get the axis XN. I have already told in previous video that the XN can be found by just elongating AN, and that is what is the next point. Between ZN minus 1 and ZN there will be a common normal represented by AN. So that common normal is very important. Okay, it is a common normal. There will be a common normal represented by AN. The direction of XN will be same as AN. Okay, so you have to just extend that an. The meeting point of Zn and Xn is the origin of the frame. So if I am going to take this frame, then here I will have this point as the origin of Zn Xn frame or Xn Zn frame, and here this point will be the origin of the Xn plus 1 Zn plus frame. Okay, what about the frame of joint n, that is Zn Xn minus 1? That we are not considering here. That will be considered when we go one step back. Okay, so that is the origin of the frame Xn Zn of joint n plus 1. Similarly, for joint n plus 2, we will have, okay, the frame Xn plus 1 and Zn plus 1. Now, there are certain special cases that I had talked about. The special case is if two consecutive z axes are parallel to each other. Okay, if they are parallel to each other, let me draw and explain it. If they are parallel to each other, suppose there is an axis like this, z axis, another axis which is parallel to it. Now we can draw the common normal, since both of them are parallel, we can draw the common normal here, or we can draw the common normal here, or we can, anywhere we can draw. So what is the rule here? The rule here is that now this axis will have a common normal previous to it. Okay, that common normal is perpendicular to this axis Z. So let us say that it is Z3. So between Z3 and Z4, the common normal will be drawn by elongating the same common normal that we had previously. So this will be the common normal, and if you remember, the common normal is always based on, if you look at the numbering, it will be based on A4, okay, because it is for Z4, it will be A4, correct. And that we have to elongate here, and we will get X4, and this is the origin of the frame X4, Z4. So if the two axes are parallel, then we just elongate the previous common normal and we will get the new common normal between the two axes which are parallel to each other. That is the first point. Now the second point is, if suppose both of them are intersecting, so suppose if I am having one z axis like this and another z axis goes completely like this, 90 degree, can be 90 degree, it can be 5 degree, it can be any degree, but the important point here is that they are intersecting at some point. So common normal will be the shortest distance between the two axes, and here the shortest distance is not, you know, between here, it's not between this, there's nothing. The common normal, in these two intersecting cases will be exactly the point where the two axes are meeting, and there the common normal will be zero. So suppose if it is, this is Zn and this is Zn plus 1, we know that this will be An plus 1, and that An plus 1 will be equal to 0. Okay, the distance An plus 1 will be equal to 0, and obviously if you want to find out the x-axis, we have to, you know, elongate that, and for doing that you have to take the cross product of Zn cross Zn plus 1. Okay, and always remember, when you do the cross product, A cross B, if suppose it is giving C, it will be always following the, you know, right hand rule, that whatever is the direction of A that you have, suppose it is going in this direction, and suppose this is B, the cross product of A cross B will be, according to right hand rule, it will come out like this. So C will be in this direction. If suppose A was here and B was here, so A was here and B was here, and A cross B means you are going in this direction, then according to the right hand rule, the direction of C will be always going inside the page. Okay, so you have to take care of the cross product, you have to always follow the right hand rule. Okay, so this is the summary of the first step of the general procedure.